Hello, this is Wojciech Pietrzak again. I'm going to start online World Cup, which is going to last for the whole weekend, 4 games a day, 8 games in total Swiss system. But the Swiss system bases on the ITSL ratings rather than Steam ratings, and the effect is that the first turn is against a player with quite similar rating to me, which should not rather happen in Swiss. Duck and Covid, a very nice nickname, held by Joe Mustard, whom I already met in Thessaloniki, also in Swiss system and also in turn one. In Thessaloniki convention I won the game. I hope to repeat it now. Let's wait for him. The time limit is going to be 60 minutes per game, and exceedings must be claimed, because otherwise the tournament can simply not go on. Let's wait several minutes. Before he appears. But if he appears late enough, I'm going to claim that he has even less time. The games are going to be played with a bid setup using Playdex system. Playdex system of bidding operates on a single bidding. Each player bids plus for USA or for USSR if he wishes, and whoever wins the bids gets the preferred superpower. If both players bid equal, the engine draws the superpowers. I should give a few more minutes without any penalty for my opponent, because the pairings are generated, and well, we are the fourth pair, but there are about 15 or 16 pairs, maybe even more. I don't remember the exact number of players this year, but it's clearly above 30. Going to message my opponent on WhatsApp. And well, when you see this game, it's probably far over the whole tournament, because I'm going to prepare and place the games after they are all played. I simply don't want to abuse myself going back and forth. And my opponent confirmed that he's going to be ready soon. And we start. So the first turn should be quite normal, so I will bid the standard 2 for USA, and I got USSR. This would be a great hand for USA, but for USSR it's also quite nice. The problem is, there is no straightforward headline with this hand. I don't like Vietnam revolts on turn 1 with DEFCON at 5 with no duck and cover on my side. Middle East scoring is going to be a pain, but not as big as it is, because I have 5-year plan. I think Olympic Games it is. US Japan is quite an interesting headline. And 2 victory points. Oh, good. Okay. Italy coup, because there's no better chance. And please, 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 4 or more. 1 is not 4 or more. Okay, so it's probably useless to fight for Europe for the moment. The plan for the rest of the turn is Warsaw Pact for coup in Iran, Vietnam revolts, check whether to score Middle East or play it with 5-year plan, Marshall Plan, probably space, blockade, late in turn, but for ops. Maybe this is the time for Vietnam revolts. Actually, DEFCON is at 4 and he threatens going to Thailand soon. If he coups, it's not a big deal. I can counter coup and I have advantage. The only bad thing would be if he had couped and zeroed it. So let's hope he doesn't clear Vietnam entirely. If it's necessary to control Thailand, I am going to give up Marshall Plan and allow him trigger the event, which means I'd probably never dominate Europe and I'd have to fight for to avoid being dominated. Unless some combo of Suez Crisis, De Gaulle and socialist governments helps. And maybe returning blockade. Brush war is mediocre. When it comes, there are probably better targets than Italy. Duck and Coffee, this is the great nickname. I messaged my opponent yesterday that he's already the winner of the World Cup, if it's about the best nickname. And guess what? He cleared Vietnam. Okay, but now Warsaw Pact formed is actually a 4-ops card for Malaysia coup. So couping back and forth looks quite promising for me. Influence. Wise. Okay, it's time to secure Thailand. I have no better candidate for it than blockade. I don't want to play Marshall now, because ops from Marshall would be vital in Asia. Only one, but when you use a 1-op card for couping a 2-step country, you shouldn't really expect a good result. It was just a Thailand securing option. I am going to trigger Marshall, but let him control France first. Of course, if he controls France and then gets there with Marshall, it's by no means a wasted op. because over-controlling France is always necessary before all the anti-French cards are gone. But yes, resolve event first. He's dominating Europe. He's better in the Middle East. So Asia is my best chance now. The bad thing is that I don't really have too many places to spend ops in Southeast Asia. I mean, I have two more in Southeast Asia or one more elsewhere, and probably South Korea would be nice. No access to Laos, Cambodia. Well, okay, Thailand and Indonesia, let's be a little greedy. The last play, of course, 5-year plan with Middle East scoring. Lebanon, Vietnam, Laos, Cambodia, Vietnam, and Lebanon if he coups. And lowers DEFCON. He did. So, Lebanon is just very important. Actually, Vietnam can wait. Laos, Cambodia is important as a country to count for Asia and Southeast Asia and as an access gainer. But there are some better places, I guess. South or North Korea? South Korea. Let's create a little crisis here for him. I don't like this warning because it's not a DEFCON warning. When I hold a scoring card, it's technically not a DEFCON suicide. It's some other kind of suicide. Okay, now socialist governments plus Europe scoring would be welcome. On the other hand, cooing versus not cooing is a 4-VP swing. On the other hand, it should be actually a 2-VP swing, because one of my war cards should be in his hand next turn, statistically. But I don't really like the way the game went, because I'm actually losing in Europe. I'm merely drawing Asia, with no real chance to dominate it, and he's dominating Middle East. But the good thing is that Middle East scoring is gone, and I'm likely to dominate Middle East before it comes back again. If I were in his shoes, I would secure Panama. No, Costa Rica would be my choice. I wasn't in his shoes. Okay. CIA and Duck and Cover. And actually a nasty hand with far too many low op cards. And I think I have to give up CIA very soon. Because if he plays Fiddle, it's going to be very difficult for me to get rid of this. And I don't really care if he sees this hand or not. Because there's nothing special in this hand for him to see. Asia scoring, it's interesting to play scoring in the headline. He didn't have to do it. He could fight for domination, although it would be difficult. Yes, I agree. Not really sure what to hold. But CIA, yes. Before he plays Fiddle and makes some mess. Now he doesn't even have two good coup targets. I think Lebanon is actually the best. And he thought so too. I don't like that he cleared it, because now if I coup battleground, he gets there. If I get there, he may coup again. But if he coups again, I may counter coup with back and cover. Or coup Panama with higher card. Anyway, if he kinda sorta checked me using the chess terminology with his zero coup in Lebanon, I responded with check back. Europe scoring, and I think this was premature. He really should have cooed and dropped DEFCON. Oh, sorry. Yeah, duck and cover it. Speaking of which, duck and cover goes to space. East European unrest is just transferring ops elsewhere from Europe. And of course I'm going to attack Panama. And this rolled great. I'm thinking about holding duck and cover just to get rid of it for longer. Yes, this was wise, because this was exactly where I was going to play my next moves if given the option. So now the priorities shift. Of course he can retake Egypt and Libya, but this gets vulnerable to Muslim revolution and makes Sadat and Camp David almost painless. Plus I have targets for ops now. Romanian abdication to Burma to make more targets. And then the priority is probably Iraq and one to South Korea. Generally, fight for Asia, ignore Europe because there's nothing special to be done there, and not lose Middle East. Korean War, yes. It's unlikely to succeed for me, and if it fails, South Korea belongs to him. I don't want to allow it. So, one here to be able to take it with the China card. If he uses the war, I lose, and he puts both influence here. One to Burma to get access. And two to Iraq. Despite Sadat waiting for me some time in the mid-game, I should probably control Egypt just to threaten dominating Middle East after coupling a battleground. It's really preparing for this Korean War. Well, I'm really denying. Of course, I don't want to have this threat looming to forever, so the problem now is if he plays it, succeeds, then I fail. And places two there, it's a perfect AR7 play. I face crisis. And I have to give up my double ground coup or give up South Korea. On the other hand, I can play Romanian abdication to France and put him in the same situation. But it's not the same. He can control France with Korean War and still threaten Korea. Decisions, decisions. I really wouldn't like to use the China card now, but it seems it's necessary in the long run. So let's score as many as possible in Southeast Asia. And let's prepare for a one Korean War, because this is a perfect situation for me to roll 5 or 6 for Korean War. Of course, I would like to win this war and wouldn't feel it was wasted or what. That would be ironic. One into North Korea, I don't like it. I don't like it because it creates no crisis for me. Oh, it does, I gave him a China card. But it creates no crisis for me because he knows I have duck and cover, so tough decision now. Socialist governments or Red Scare? If socialist governments, then Red Scare for coup, and if he takes North Korea, I don't take France, and so no Red Scare for coup. Probably East European unrest for couping. Middle East scoring, always worth getting rid of. Okay, so now, if I coup, now what? I can still change my mind, so I'm gonna take from United Kingdom just to play special relationship freely. Middle East is gone for long. So, if I coup Algeria, he may either take France or North Korea, but not both. And he doesn't have coup. And I have roll. And even if he takes North Korea, He doesn't dominate Asia, of course. He has 3 VPs for Asia, 2 for Battlegrounds, and 1 for Adjacency. He may get 4th for Afghanistan. This is quite nice. But he doesn't dominate it. I have 7 countries, and I need only 3 ops to get 8th. Really? North Korea and China card rather than France. Okay, but you know, you can't dominate Asia actually. I think I haven't seen Josip Broz Tito coming. So if I wait for him. Yes, I could. Okay. I could play Romanian abdication for the event and immediately dominate Europe. Things to remember about. Space duck and cover, over control France. This is just against him taking it. Yes, he can take Taiwan. And have 4. VPs for Asia, but he's not threatening to dominate Asia by the number of countries. Does he have? He has this tower. East European unrest should actually go with the event after ops. Because it's wise to place ops in Greece, to which I only have Bulgarian access. Bulgaria is a funny country. It's an Eastern European country with only Western European adjacencies. Sure, space duck and cover next, and see if spacing defectors is an option. Yes, Korean War, of course. Five versus 4. In for a penny, in for a pound. I very much like to space defectors because it's a 5 VP swing, potentially. To be the first to gain the 3rd space race and to disallow him getting victory point from defectors. Romanian abdication is now quite empty because it doesn't give me domination in Europe anyway. And this succeeded. And I really don't like to be skipped on by the one small step just to reach the third step by the opponent. If he now has a 4-ops card, he may break France and threaten Truman.3. I can't do much about it, but it's a little costly for him. So the regions stabilized, mid-war regions are slightly in my favor, and victory point track is slightly in my favor, so this all looks much better than it looked after the first turn. And I used 14 minutes and 9 seconds for the early war. This is acceptable with 60 minutes per game. So what can he have? I must admit I hadn't paid attention to the cards. I should have remembered this, but I didn't. I only remember he has Distal. South African Unrest, Alliance for Progress. Nice, nice. So South African Unrest to Angola and South Africa. Then Alliance for Progress coup Libya. That's the plan. Europe scoring. He's very eager to headline scorings. This is a risky strategy, but it somehow pays off for him. So, this is gone for free. I probably play OPEC for OPS, because even 4 VPs are not as valuable at this stage of the game. What I don't like is Panama Canal returned, and I should prepare against it. And what I don't like is that he can play Che freely if he has it. But Che appearing on turn 4 is never a good news for the Soviets. I also don't like this. But this opens some options. For example, spreading in multiple directions at once. If he takes China card from me, I can't do anything about it. I prefer this than allowing him trigger Usuri River Skirmish with no China card in my hand. If he has both Usuri and Nixon, I can't do anything about it, literally. Now, arms raised for cooing. One thing worth noting is that if I wanted to get 3 ops, 3 victory points instead of 3 ops, I could do it with arms race. I didn't feel it would be good, and I don't feel it would be good to do it with OPEC. coup for coup is risky, I probably should have gone with more ops in Colombia, but this would be impossible with to combine with threatening multiple places at once. The drawback of my play is that things I do now lessen the impact of destalinization eventually played by him. That was another drawback. I'm not really sure what should I do now. One option is 3 to Venezuela, but if he coups Zaire, it's suddenly annoyingly hard to keep Southern Africa and to get Nigeria. The other option is Saharan States, Cameroon and Venezuela, which renders Venezuela vulnerable for cooing. Third option is... if I had a 2-ops card, it would be Saharan States and Cameroon, but I don't have. So let's threaten here and let's try walking this way. No battleground cooing. Yes, Zaire, as predicted. The question is, can I allow playing China card? Or playing Asknot? Let's make it funny. Actually, what's the order of cards? Asknot last. Panama Canal last but one gives him important access. No. Panama Canal should be a hold card. In this case, Brezhnev goes for ops, so that was quite fortunate. Even if he coups Angola with success, which he does. I can create multiple threats at once. Come on, you still have destalinization and you still haven't spaced the star. UN intervention, how nice. How nice because now Asknot doesn't seem very helpful for him. And what is more to the point, Panama Canal is not a big problem for me. I'm actually thinking of playing the Panama Canal and but not. If he has one card and he played UN intervention with Distal, the one he left may not be suicidal and is probably spaceable, so there won't be better chance to get rid of Mr. Kennedy. Yes, he didn't discard anything. Access to Brazil and access to Chile. Thank you. the nuclear test ban worked quite well. Nuclear subs, sorry, worked quite well for him. This has to be admitted. Asia's Coric and APM Treaty. And APM Treaty is going to be my headline. Mostly because I want to coup Pakistan and I really wanted to do it successfully. Okay. What's the most annoying card now? I feel I'm lucky with rolls this game. Of course, he does have a battleground coup now. Well, this couldn't be helped. But the situation isn't as bad as it could be. The worst news for me is actually that I don't have a good order of cards to play. I mean, I should take Brazil as soon as possible. I should play shuttle diplomacy as late as possible. And anyway, after I play Asia Scoring, I should play containment last. I probably shouldn't play China. This means I must play Muslim Revolution to take Brazil. Chile as an access gainer to Argentina. And Pakistan, the over-control of which is always desirable. Yeah. Okay, he managed to do it for free. This couldn't be better anyway. Now I am quite free to play shuttle diplomacy. Central America, Africa, Southeast Asia. Scorings, which are waiting. And I have my opinion about which scoring he has. Panama Canal returned is now an event which does nothing, and Venezuela is still realignable. Africa needs more attention, however. This was quite weird. He really needs VPs so much, but in this case I think he may have forgotten about blockade, so maybe I even hold containment and play blockade on my AR7. Anyway, such a good position for realignments is quite rare, so it should be used. And yes, Venezuela is important enough to perform realignments there even if the scoring is gone. I feel I should play faster because he has more time. On the other hand, I should care about my time, not his, and my time is okay. I will end the fifth turn with more than half an hour remaining. Oh no, 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 no. You are not going to have such good modifiers against Cuba, or you are going to have these modifiers. Oh well. And this couldn't rather be helped. The good thing is he may be tempted to use High Ops card and fall into blockade. Actually, it was a quite nice response to my realignments from him. So, show me. Show me, show me. Five-year plan, oh. And he had Central America scoring, so Africa is the only scoring remaining. Defectors are gone, aren't they? Of course they are. Turn 3. So Quagmire is a safe play. He can, of course, headline Africa scoring. I said something about Prush War, but this is actually a map where Prush War against Italy looks very promising. Camp David, puppet governments, John Paul. I hope to hold one of these and space two of these. Puppet governments is worst. Camp David is the least important. Missile envy. Yeah, I remembered it, but this is never a reason to play a card like Flower Power for headline. What really hurts me is that it grabs me a battleground coup. But it's quite fortunate that his coup is repairable by Missile Envy. Ouch, he succeeded. And things don't look that good now. Well, Africa must be fought for. This is important to remember in Twilight Struggle when you claim that you have hand full of your opponent nasty events. Always remember, if you have your opponent's events, it's very likely he has yours. Of course, the nastiest USA events didn't appear so far. I mean grain sales to Soviets and Voice of America. But I also hadn't seen this one. I hadn't seen We Will Bury You. I hadn't seen Che. I don't expect seeing them because they probably would have priority over this. On the other hand, he might be untempted to give up Angola. On the other hand, he could have played it and realigned Angola. So I can fight for Zaire or Italy with Brashwar. They are both won with 50%. And they both give me domination. Italy dominates the more important region, but actually not higher scoring. I mean, Italy is a 6 VP swing, Zaire is a 5 VP swing, but Zaire is easier coupable with other means. He's paced, so I think I'm gonna space now and wait for him. And I fortunately failed the space roll, so I'll be able to space one more card. He doesn't have 5-year plan and missile envy, so he can't really mess up with my hand. Long gunman is in the deck, Kennedy is not in the deck, CIA is not in the deck, so this looks promising, optimistic, and so on so far. And he rolled quite poorly now. Okay, let's attempt another time. This failed again. Actually, if this had succeeded, it would be good to see his headlines. But it would also mean I could no longer space two ops cards like Voice of America and Grain Sales. Oh yes, the Southeast Asia scoring is waiting. So Camp David Accords, as said, is not a big deal. African domination, it's a much bigger deal. And yeah, South America needs taking care of. Allende can wait, because it's a very good headline and not a big deal if it falls to defectors. Brush war against Venezuela or Egypt are tempting, because the chance is increased. Oh, a rich hand. He has so rich hand that I actually think I could play containment and this would change nothing. Okay. Except from equalizing Africa, of course. Another tempting thing is to put Allende to Somalia, sorry, Ethiopia, just to have one more country in Africa, but let's see what he does. Because as said, I haven't seen Che, and Che could turn the tables. Of course, the first coup against Haiti, but the second one against Tunisia, why not? dominated Africa. So brush work 50% and no chance to use it on Italy. Or agenda to keep Africa quite equal, quite, because it's still 3 for him. But yeah, 3 is not 7. Southeast Asia, and he knows I had it. And ouch, I have 5-year plan and I have grain size and Voice of America. So grain size for space, 5-year and voice to hold, so I should play China card and I should do it quickly. Certainly before he... takes it from me. So, Willy Brandt, because it's not a big deal if it goes under defectors. And then coup with the China card. If he takes me the China card, I think grain sales to space and 5-year plan to space ASAP. Colonial rear guards just have to be suffered in this case. I'm actually not sure what should I do with this China card. I mean, I know I should coup, but where? There are many tempting targets. Zaire, Algeria, Iran, Egypt, Venezuela, Mexico. Junta. ABM, wow. Thailand. Actually, it's quite good that he equalized it. I mean zeroed it. Because I'll be able to just go there directly. Algeria is hardest to flip. Usually. Of course, I would like to roll better, but the main goal was to keep him busy and drop DEFCON. The next play is quite straightforward. Control Thailand, score Southeast Asia, space grain sales. And then see what happens. He has chair. I think he has junta. I didn't see it. He has penalized himself. Okay, Brazil is first. Before Thailand, because he doesn't have access to Thailand anyway, and I still have one more card which I can play without any punishment. Well, I have Brush War, but if I have to play Brush War for Ops, this means something very bad happened. I smell South America scoring coming. Maybe this is a good moment to play Brush War against Venezuela. No, it's not. I mean, I should wait until it really protects me from his domination. And that was quite hurtful because he probably has Truman and I have no good cards to respond now. So, okay, I have to play just mine moves. Maybe I should have played, yes, into Poland. This was a nice combo of him. Okay, grain sales, space race to Soviets. Success. But I may no longer space two ops cards. I probably shouldn't leave 5-year plan and Voice of America in my hand with no China, so I think I'm gonna space 5-year plan. On the other hand, may be useful to get rid of some annoying scoring. Well, of course, Voice of America and Colonial Rare Cards is much worse hand than 5-year plan and Voice of America. Okay, it's brush war time against Italy. Boo. Europe is 4-6 for him and I can't do anything about it. And it's also very vulnerable to tear down this wall and Chernobyl combo. So, one probable outcome is that he wins by European control. The other probable outcome is that I win by war games. Among others like DEFCON Suicide or probably the least probable now, the final scoring. And of course there's always something like time exceeding. Mi compadre. Haiti goes first. Tunisia goes second. Yeah, this is a good moment to push victory points. Better scorings that could come. We'll better use his headline actually. So he's going to drop DEFCON. So he probably has UN intervention, and I have Aldrich Ames, and I can take UN intervention from his hand. doesn't have UN intervention. He does have the reformer, Muslim Revolution, Latin American Debt Crisis, Ortega, and America's scorings. Quite easily fight for America. What do I wish him to lose? Ortega is a good card in his hand. Both America's callings are good cards in his hand. Latin American Debt Crisis, he probably played to discard the reformer, but in this case he has to play the entire hand with China. I think arms race. And now that I know you have these scorings, wait. Yeah, okay. I can't really decide. Okay. Why not? It makes Latin American crisis in his hand actually a crisis. Is going to fight for. Central America. Okay, let's start from attempting to clear Venezuela. And I think he should score South America now. I should probably play Nixon ASAP. Two victory points are not such a big deal now as the China card, but well, he does have it. Okay, let's play it now and save these victory points at least. I might have done it all wrong, since he's likely to have. Both scorings played in his favor, as expected. Okay, socialist governments no longer playable for the event. What does he have left? Four cards. Two scorings. Muslim Revolution. And the Iron Lady. This is worth risking. Now I have military operations and he does not. South America for one in his favor, yes. Colonial rear guards, which hurt. What my best option to score something important from Middle East, because if he wants to dominate Central America he has to give me the Muslim Revolution. Excuse me. Suddenly, I'm out of sources of victory points. Middle East is for minus one now. Central America is for minus one. Asia and Africa are all in his favor. Europe, better don't say. And I have 20 minutes remaining for my last two turns. Nicely played by him. Oh, two. I miscalculated something. I'm really worried about Africa or Asia, but I just couldn't fight for each region. I really, maybe going to Libya was a mistake. On the other hand, he didn't expect me. Let's wait for his headline. By some miracle, he's still not dominating Asia. And I got into Pakistani war. most important thing, however, is to deny him African control. Kitchen debates. But do you really have more? 1, 2, 3, 4 versus 2. Plus 2 for him, plus 3 for him, plus 2 for him. Oh yes, Africa. Plus 7 for him. Okay, so can't really be helped. In this case, red square purge. Accept kitchen debates. And the funny thing is that East European unrest is almost free. Okay. First things first. Why is it DEFCON warning? Oh, yes, because Star Wars is a potentially DEFCON suicide event, but not in this case. Okay, three great realignment role targets in Africa. One great card in the Pakistani war. So our man in Tehran probably as soon as possible to Israel to deny its effect. Olympic Games as soon as possible to Laos, Cambodia and Vietnam if given chance. East European unrest space. Voice of America hold. Allende, let's see. Ouch. Why did you have it? If it goes to the final scoring, I think I'm lost. Because there are just too many things on the map that went wrong. Only one for from OPEC, but at least this worked. Maybe there's still a chance. Okay, high roll done. Now it's time for a low roll. East European unrest. Right on time. High roll again. Wow. Not what I wanted. Still headed to space. Resolve event first. Realigning Zaire and hope to clear it. Single row, Okay, so Venezuela gets a second chance. Whew. 7 I'm one up and one coup from dominating Africa again. And he had been controlling it at the beginning of this turn. Oh, he's dominating it again, but not for a long time. Maybe there's a chance in the final scoring. Actually, now I score map higher than him, I guess. However, his lack of presence in Middle East and Central America is very temporary. And his advantages, except Africa, I mean his advantage in Europe, is stable. There'll be details deciding about this game. I think it may end up in the final scoring with less than 5 victory points of victory margin. And such circumstances usually favor USA. And the good thing is that with Swiss system, even losing the first round doesn't mean you can't win the tournament. And actually, in all the previous edition of this World Cup, which were World Championships, the future champions always lost something. Sometimes even 2 games out of 8. And there's still a chance to some combo of Iranian hostage crisis, and boosted terrorism. No longer. Terrorism is in his hand, actually. Deco is the last card I'd like to see drawn by terrorism. I'm not happy with this as well, but I have to play Voice of America on myself. Attack and cover to Thailand is tempting. I mean, he can give me the China card. But this is still the China card, so it's one VP swing. And if I don't play duck and cover, let's face it, I have to play an Evil Empire, which is also one VP. Has to secure Asia somehow. P An evil empire is an obvious candidate to space, but there aren't candidates to fight for Africa otherwise. On the other hand, I may try to sacrifice Africa and fight for Algeria, or just to play Pershing deployed. For ops. This is enough to stop him here. This is enough to secure Asia. Voice of America needs to be played ASAP. So nasty to play it on oneself. Okay, he does have Africa. Ouch. And he does want to score it. Okay, I can't afford not spacing it. Or can I? No, I can't. Ouch, I really needed this roll. No. If he scores Africa, he can force draw with war games. But he doesn't. He goes for Central America. Okay, let's have it done. And maybe suggest him that I have some suicide in my hand. Things to be done. Repair damage, fight for South America, coup with Reagan. Save Asia. Probably still lose. Yeah, it's lost unless he has something suicidal. But I really can't see what could it be. perishing only if it's a lifesaver due to one victory point, because taking three from Europe is repairable by one to regain domination. He, for example, denies me Libya and frees Regan. There is a small chance, okay, but I don't think it's meaningful. Of course, Thailand has higher priority because Pakistan is out of reach for him now. Okay, perishing deployed. I finally resign from this. And try to fight here. Next, move Chernobyl to Venezuela and Chile, if he allows. And on the very last move, cooing something with Regan. Probably Cameroon. Hoping that he would have to space something. And have no coup and no domination in Africa. Is my chance, but requires some mistakes of his side, and well, even cooing with a China card would be better in this case, and he's really able to find it. Okay. Created some sort of crisis in Africa. Oh, but he remembered the coup. And he succeeded in cooing. Of course, no resolving event first in case of Chernobyl. 5-4. Let's wait with this coup to see if it can change the outcome of Africa. But actually, even if it doesn't, there are no better targets to coup than Cameroon. I need 4 or more to control Cameroon. I need 5 or more to control Botswana. And I need 6 to control Tunisia. He was thinking very long about his Voice of America move. So I really wonder What is he keeping for his last play? Whatever it is, it's probably very nasty for me. The very nasty surprise would be now Africa scoring. My African bombs Libya, making it 6, and then him having all the time in the world to calculate war games or not. And this roll succeeded, and it is at least a little forcing for him. He now lost domination in Africa in a single roll. He can regain it, but yes, probably Venezuela and Africa and he won by 8 points. Thanks for watching, and next games are coming.